the tying run at the plate.
And that one fouled off.
Kicks and fires.
Stays alive.
Got to put good velocity in the head of the hitter. He's got to get it ready early and then change speeds. Keep him off balance. That's the goal.
Next offering is fouled back. One, two now. Off the outside edge, and now the count is 2-2. Got him. And two away now.
It's a good breaking ball there, just off the corner where you can't really do much damage, but it's close enough to where you've got to protect, and he just couldn't find a way to fight it off.
Miguel Sano now at the plate. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all. The next offering misses. And one and one. The pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's a 1-2. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Twins are set down 1-2-3. They're down 3-2. New pitcher on now, Jorge Alcala. It's his job to keep his team in the game. Back in Minnesota, all set to start the ninth in this one. And now the right fielder, Robbie Groth. Into center. Buxton drifts towards it, hauls it in for the out.
Now batting the left fielder, Austin Meadows.
Now at the plate, Austin Meadows. First pitch, not close. Bullpen activity starting up now. Joe Smith getting loose out there. Stashek getting cranked up as well. Pulls that one foul. One run game here in the top of the ninth. Next pitch is inside and a count 2-1. That one misses in the dirt. Next offering is fouled back. Payoff pitch. On the ground, right side. And he handles it himself for the out.
Now batting.
And first offering is fouled off. That one not close. 1-1.
Not looking like they'll be adding any insurance runs heading to the bottom of the ninth, so it's going to be on the bullpen to hold this lead.
This one is smashed down the right field line. Way back there. Fair and gone. Javi Baez goes the other way. His second home run of the game, and they tack one on the board. It's 4-2.
A slider right down the middle of the plate, it's like slow motion for a hitter. You're just licking your chops, waiting for it to arrive, and you want to hit it a long way, and he did.
Two outs, nobody on. Jamer Candelario up now for the Tigers.
The third baseman.
Jamer. And that's in there for strike one. And a pitch. And that one hit to first. He handles it himself, and that'll do it. Tigers add one to the lead on this homer. It's now 4-2. On the same course where we stay. Relativity abounds, so it suits ya. We all have different visions of a future. What you think lie ahead for the coming days? New leaves are on the same course where we stay. Relativity abounds, so it suits ya. We all have different visions of a future. Welcome back. Last chance for the home team. Digging in, Gio Urshela.
The third baseman, number
Chafin,
15.
Back to work. Good eye right there. Line drive to short and caught. Here's Carlos Correa.
Shortstop, Carlos Correa.
Swings and fouls one off.
Hey, look, we'll see how it factors in. I just can't emphasize how much that insurance run in the top of the ninth means. I mean, just such a big difference mentally when you're chasing two runs instead of one.
Kicks and deals. Out towards left center. Meadows makes the grab. Two down.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
Kepler now in the box. Comes up empty with a swing there. Sharp grabber, that's through for a base hit. Dives, but it kicks off his glove. He's in there.
One out away from this game being over, but an infield single keeps him alive. They're still breathing, and maybe this provides that last-minute spark.
So now a pinch hitter, Jose Miranda. Runner on first and two gone for. Now they turn to Alex Reyes, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead.
So he's having an excellent season so far. ERA is under two. A lot of flexibility coming out of the bullpen.
First offering misses the mark. Two-run game, a two away here in the bottom of the ninth. Ground ball up the middle. That one's sizzling on its way through to the outfield. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
That's back-to-back singles for him. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Jeffers in the box now. Takes strike one. Just one out away, trying to close it out. Stays alive. And the 0-2. Got him! And that's the ball game.
Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.
And your final, 4-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Tigers, 4 runs on 10 hits. No errors. They left 9 runners.
I've been talking to guy about the garages for the crib that I still have on by. Boat rocking my thoughts, going too fast and irrational. I need the 42 in the way. I'm the ambassador, meaning I gas up the land I came from. Make it rain and the money look in like ransoms. And my brain always steady demand the answers. I've been feeling like I'm fighting with my thoughts.
Inside the show with Justin Allegri.
Hi, I'm Justin Allegri, and this is your Wednesday edition of Inside the Show. In the AL Central, the Tigers put together 10 total hits as they defeated the Twins in the Twin Cities 4-2. The Chicago White Sox allowed only 5 hits in the game as they beat the visiting Red Sox 3-1. The Guardians put up 16 hits on the day as they got a win over the Astros in Houston 5-2. Brady Singer got his second W of the season as the Royals.